this is the SAP Developer News for December 4th, 2025.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. Important announcement, if you are planning to attend UI5con in Bengaluru in December, unfortunately, due to unforeseen circumstances, the event had to be postponed. They're targeting mid-January now. Check out the UI5con website for all the updates, and registration opens soon, so keep an eye on that. And hope to talk to you soon. Bye.
Good morning from Birmingham. Day three, the last day of UKISUG Connect 2025. It's been great. We had on the first day, on the Sunday, a whole lot of workshops, hands-on workshops, great discussions took place there, as they did on Monday. Full of talks, great keynote, and today we've got a keynote. I'm about to leave shortly to join that keynote and listen in to what Timo has to say today. And then there's going to be a series of talks as well. It's been great. UKISUG Connect is always a great conference to attend. It's connections, reconnections, sharing and learning together. It's been a fun and honourable time here because I gave a workshop on Sunday and a talk on Monday, which seemed to go down well. I'm not sure. It's all a bit random. But anyway, that's how it goes. Fantastic. Well, signing out from UKISUG Connect 2025, and see you soon.
Let's examine the engineering behind the new UI5. -create-app feature in Joule for SAP Build Code, as shared by Andreas Kunz in his recent blog post. So, the team treated the LLM like a true agent. First, define the goal. Second, specify the tools and constraints. Third, preload relevant project context, and then let the model reason its way to a solution. Joule analyzes user requirements, gathers project details like folder structure, cap services, Git state, and returns a hidden JSON configuration that drives deterministic template generation. After app creation, deterministic code takes over for tasks like dependency setup, while the LLM shifts into the guidance mode. The key lessons for everyone building AI developer tooling: combine LLM flexibility with precise tooling and strong context to deliver a smart developer experience, and use deterministic code for everything predictable. For the full architecture and deeper insights, check out the original article on SAP Community.
One of my favorite command line tools, the BTP CLI, has just had an upgrade. It's in the form of a new group, a command group to manage destinations. So alongside accounts, services, and security, there's now a new group, connectivity, with various objects to help you manage destinations. These new objects are experimental, and the BTP CLI team would love to hear from you, to hear your feedback. Just use, as usual, the BTP feedback command to trigger that. Link to the documentation for the new objects is in the description.
We are pleased to announce the launch of Data Architect Learning Journey, the first fundamental stage of the Becoming a Data Architect curriculum. The structured program covers four units. Unit 1 focuses on foundational concepts, data modeling, metadata management, and alignment with frameworks like Zachman and Togaf. Unit 2 explores model paradigms, including data mesh, data fabric, data lake, and lakehouse, alongside integration methods like ETL or ELT. Unit 3 addresses governance, security, and strategic impact, including stewardship, data lineage, and compliance for AI/ML, while Unit 4 develops communication and leadership skills to articulate the architectural value and drive change. Designed for data engineers, architects, and IT specialists, this journey builds expertise from theory to strategic application. It also prepares you for the upcoming SAP-certified data architect specialization in 2026. Enroll now and let us know what you think.
I'm on my way to SAP Tech at Berlin.
See you in Berlin.
See you in Berlin.
See you in Berlin.
See you in Berlin.
Berlin.
We'll be right back.
next stop?
Sydney!
Hello from Sydney, Australia.
Next stop, Bengaluru.
Next stop, Bengaluru.
Then when I participated and entered all the sessions and did all the hands-on sessions as well, it was very much knowledgeable. And then I actually implemented it after that, winning the whole thing. So yeah, this year I implemented in projects as well. So that was a win. So yeah, it was very informative. And the best thing that I liked about it was the scavenger hunt and the crossword puzzles. Those were like super exciting. And super thrilled to, solve all of this. It was really exciting.
That sounds really great. And now we are here in Berlin on TechEd. So any highlights here? Anything you want to point out?
Oh yeah, the hands-on sessions were great. I attended the hands-on session for the AI piece of it. I built the Joule skills, the Joule agents and everything. So I attended the Joule sessions, basically the hands-on sessions, and to build the Joule skill and see the agents working end-to-end. That was the highlight for me. And I am primarily a UI developer, so seeing the build, transform from where it was and now I can use Joule in it, that was really super exciting. And yeah, I'm looking forward to implementing what I've learned here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.